doing here is because it comes from the invisible. I have a fridge in my home and it makes ice. Now the fridge is connected to the water in the house. Right. So as the water comes into the fridge, then it freezes and then it creates what?
Ice.
Everything you do, and we have preached on this, everything Sister Gloria do, she conceived a thought, an idea that came from somewhere.
Yes.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? Yes. Everything Sister Gloria or me or any one of you do, that thought came from where? Somewhere. Then once we get that thought, if it is strong, you understand? We then turn that thought into a plan. Are you listening to what I'm saying? So the water comes in the fridge and the fridge turns it into ice. Every thought that comes into your head, no matter where it comes from, unless you know to, if you reject it, if you don't reject it, it starts to form into an ice to become what? A plan. And when that plan comes to a certain ice, congeal, you understand? You give birth, the Bible said, to a manifest station. That becomes your what? Reality.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? The only way it doesn't become a reality in your life, if when the thoughts came, you go, no, I reject it. This is why the Bible teaches us in 2 Corinthians 10, take every thought captive. Do I want it to form and become ice?
Yes, amen, amen.
Because if it form and become ice and it manifests, is it good for people to drink and need to drink? So this is why, as Pastor tells it, when you just the thoughts come in your head, and the thoughts go, oh, you are nobody. And then you go, yes, I am nobody, I'm nobody, I'm stupid, I'm this. As you start to do this, then it becomes what? Ice.
Yes.
It's called a formation. It forms in you. And then, at a certain time, just like Jazzy baby or any one of us start with what? One spermatoza. But then, as it stay, if she don't reject it, you know, if she don't reject that baby, what happens? It starts to what? Multiply and it takes form and then it comes out into what? Beautiful coal or Kaya Justice or someone like that. Do you understand this principle? Believe me, what you are experiencing is as a result of what you accept or what you create. You see? And even there are thoughts we create too, but it's always based on your experience. What you have heard or what you have went through. We can only create similar thoughts. Similar thoughts, meaning right. It has a reference.
Yes.
But we can receive what? New thoughts. Ones that we have never what? Experienced.
Yes, yes.
Both from God and from what? The devil. So both God and the devil are fighting for real estate.
Yes.
A place they can plant the seed.
And make ice.
Make ice and then get the ice what? Manifested.
Yes, yes.
Now the Bible teaches us in 1 John, the whole world except the church is under the control of what? The devil. They're all his ice machine.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Pastor, look at the 1 John, I think it's 4:4. Read that scripture for 4:20, sorry.
1 John 4:20?
Yeah.
First John 5:19. Amen.
Please read.
We know positively.
Listen, we know, you say absolutely. What do we know?
We know absolutely, positively, that we are of God. Mm-hmm. And the whole world around us is under the power of the evil one.
All of them is under. But we know the only thought supposed to come in our head is from what? God. The church is the ice machine that God can put his thoughts, God's revelation. You understand? It can form the, after the thoughts come, you understand? The thoughts will not take hold until you start to identify with it. You start to go, I like this. Or like, that's true. Until you start to add feelings in the thought doesn't become what? Do you understand? Like how many things, like the water, it has to mix with oxygen. It's when you start to lay hold of it, it becomes crystallized.
Yes. Yes.
The Bible said we have to stay consecrated. In fact, this is where you get a lot of discipline. God said, the only thoughts that are supposed to come from you are those you generate, you understand, in alignment with him or come from what? Him. Anything else, he called it adultery.
Yeah.
Right.
He said, you are allowing someone else, you understand? Excuse my depiction. The only spermatozoa my wife should have is mine. Anything else is adultery.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Anything else, it's fornic, it's adultery.
You're making someone else's ice.
Yes. She's bringing forth someone else's child, then we got a problem. Do you understand it? So God said, the old world, you understand? Until you give yourself to Christ, you know Satan have ice machine.
Yes.
Except the church. So the Holy Spirit discipline you when you lay hold of the thoughts that did not come from God or did not in alignment with God. Mm-hmm. Because as you lay hold of it and you identify with it, it will become ice. And then ice becomes what? The ice is inside here. And when someone press you, mm-hmm. or you go trust it, when you press the thing, then the ice what? Yeah, I know, Kaya Justin. That becomes our reality, or what you call your life. Or your life what? Happening. Now we typically, we talk about it, and we study this one. Most of us, we hate the kind of ice we got.
Yeah.
And then you'll try to break the ice and put the ice in the back. But when you come back tomorrow, you have the same kind of what?
Ice.
Same ice.
The Bible calls that process, you need what? Deliverance.
Yes.
You need to break the kind of water coming in what? The fridge.
Perfect.
That's right.
Perfect.
And the Bible said, you need to know positively that the only water coming into you is holy water.
Mm.
Now Pastor Joe read you just now, Agur, chapter 2, 11 to 13.
Yeah.
The Bible teaches us, you understand? We are holy, and it teaches us holy is not infectious.
Mm.
It's not contagious. So Christ was holy, and 5,000 people touching it. Does that mean they can become holy? No. Holiness is intentional. I intentionally only allowing one kind of ice to what? Come through me. What's marriage or a covenant? I have decided that not everybody can touch me. Only one person has right to me. So health or holiness is what? Intentional. Success is intentional.
Perfect.
But the Bible said, you understand? Unholiness, contamination, you understand? It is infectious. If Charles have a cold, you understand? Do I have to be intentional to get it?
No.
I just need to be in proximity. Virus, disease is infectious. You just have to be in its what? Proximity. That's the fall. Before Adam fall, it wasn't like that. This was me and my wife fellowshipping in the morning. Before Adam fall, there was no infection. Sin didn't get it. You live in a world, holiness has to be held on to and intentionally hold on, but infection and disease, you understand? Just happened. Someone got AIDS. You didn't ask for it, but you just touch them and you get what? AIDS. But someone have health and you touch them and you don't get what? Their health. It has to, this is why the disciples look at Christ and say, how do you do that? Intentionally, they have to learn how to do it.
Right.
But disease and death, amen? The infectious things can transform without any what? Intent.
They're unintentional.
Consecration is intentional. It's not infectious. You have to lay hold of it.
Mm.
Like the lady touching Jesus intentionally.
Yeah. I was thinking about like when you go to like YouTube or something, reasons why certain videos go viral is because it's posted on the most recent, most recommended, blah, blah, blah. You're not going to see most recommended sermons on the gospel of Jesus Christ. Like, you have to intentionally
follow. Yes, so you got to come after me. You have to, God is loving, but God is cheap. You have to intentionally.
Yeah.
SARS is infectious. Holiness doesn't work that way. All right, listen to what I'm saying. Holiness, or health, you understand? You know, secondhand smoking is what? Infectious.
Yes,
you understand? Health is not what? Infectious. You have to intentionally eat right, sleep right, do the things for health.
Yes, yes.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes,
so
yes.
God put this, he wanted the people to be clear with the law. He said, is holiness infectious? The priest answered, right? He goes, no. He goes, correct. You see? So he asked them, is uncleanliness infectious? They go, yes. If Jing house is unclean, you understand? Kyle and Astrid or child, just being in the environment, she can become what? Infected. But if Jing is holy, and Charles don't lay hold of it, or Kyle, can they become holy?
No.
No. They have to lay hold of it. They have to choose it.
They have to choose it. Amen.
But the law of sin is that you don't have to choose it. It just has to touch you and you didn't reject it.
Yes, yes.
Do you understand? You know, so please understand how the manifestation coming in your life. Now know also absolutely. One of the things that's terrible in the church, Then they're not supposed to touch you, but you just put the thoughts in close proximity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And if you know that, I know positively that only things are supposed to come to me, and only thoughts I am supposed to. Kind of, I said, you are made in the image, exactly like God, and the likeness. Likeness is behavior. I behave like it. Image is character. Likeness is behavior. So I'm only supposed to come up with thoughts that are what? Holy. Does that make sense? But the thoughts come close. Another water line just come close. And we just let it come in.
Yeah.
Let it form ice.
Yeah, that's a mess.
And then we had it manifested, or someone touched, pressed the release, and it come out, and then we go, that's not what I want. And then we are frustrated, or we hate ourselves, and then they don't interpret, you're a stupid ice machine. You only produce bad ice. You're producing bad ice because you have a bad line coming in.
You can't do nothing about the line.
You see, you need deliverance. And once you're delivered, then you need consecration. No other line must bring forth water in you. This process is called holy or narrow. Does this make sense?
Perfect.
Amen. This is why the gospel in Romans 7 says you cannot be justified, you cannot get out from your sin, your poor thinking, by the law. You're justified by grace. But in Galatians, the same gospel said, you cannot be sanctified by the law. You need to be sanctified by grace.
Amen.
To stay holy,
yes.
I need power to stop the barrage of thoughts. So I can't be justified by my action. You understand? But I can't stay holy by my action either.
No.
We're justified through Christ, and I stay sanctified through Christ. He's the only one who can take all the thoughts on. Captive. If not, I'll be sanctified sometime, but I'll be cussing in the next one. So this is where Paul said, how can you be so stupid? He said, out from the same fridge, on my ice machine, there's a little part you just press. He said, how could salt water and sweet ice come from the same one?
Perfect.
That should immediately tell you the fridge has two line one coming in. It's not supposed to be so. You somehow have a bad line coming in.
Yeah. We switch our faith.
So please understand. Let's wrap up. Charles, I need your help with one thing. There's two things, and this I just want to I'm encouraged by the word today. I'm encouraged by Pastor Chow's word. I'm encouraged by Sister Jing's testimony. And I want to show you where our church is and what's going
to
happen.
Yeah, I think we're starting to
walk in. And I want to share what Pastor Chow is talking about praying in the Spirit. I need Agai.
Blame my mother.
Worship, not my stir.
Daddy,
man, that I want you to bring up something. The book of Agai. Girl, you're a Mac girl. Agai chapter 1, Jazzy, and I was 1 from verse 12 to 14. Agai chapter 1. Verse 12 to 14. Yeah. And Jazzy, I'm also going to read Agai chapter 2.
Sorry, the first one's equal?
Agai chapter 1.
Yeah.
12 to 14. Literally, church, maybe 3 minutes. I just want you to see where you are. One other thing I want you to stop. Stop allowing two water lines to come in.
Yes.
You. And believe me. Now, if you can't do what I'm going to show you, what Pastor Chell talked about, if you don't know to win it in the Spirit, and I want you to see why you're not winning it in the Spirit. What typically you're messing up, you don't know to stay sanctified. Every Christian is justified. Once you accept Jesus, you go, the reason God have let me off is because he provided an atonement, a propitiation offer. This is meaning, I am let out of jail because Jackie bailed me, because Christ bailed me.
Yes.
This is the reason. Yes. That's what's called, you're justified. By faith. You have faith in the price Christ paid. But Romans, Paul tells him in Galatians, The way how you receive justification, do you think now you can go on by reverting to the law? You go, no, the same way you start has to be the same way you stay sanctified. Do you understand? The only way I'm going to stay in the line properly has to be the same way I come in. Because what they did, they came in by justification, and then they go, now I can keep all the poor thoughts, and I can discern which one should become I. You know, which is the very thing that they were going to get killed before. We had poor thoughts, we had poor formation, poor manifestation. So God said, I have to destroy you. Because when he looked at us, he said, nothing good is what? Coming for me. Jean says she found that. What she found is like the old ways created bad life, and she found there's a new source of thoughts that give good formation. Yeah. I don't know about you guys, I celebrate your life. When you look where Jean was, or any one of you, and we're, including my own, and where we are, oh, yes. I tell you. This is like your thought, what I think.
Yeah.
If, oh.
Yeah.
And now, when you start to transform, the devil don't want you to see what you have become or what God is doing with you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Jackie, let me know what you did.
Amen.
Now, I want you to see how to stay sanctified, or how to pray, or where to live from. And you have this. The Bible teaches you in Timothy, God said, I did not give you a spirit. You understand? Of fear and cowardice and timidity. And when this is not happening, you are just in the wrong dimension of you. Are we here? Mm-hmm. Can you read with me from verse 12? Where it says, then Zerubbabel.
Then Zerubbabel.
Yeah, the son of Shealtiel.
Shealtiel. And
Joshua, son of Jehoshaphat. Yeah.
The high priest and all the remnant of the people. From captivity.
So Israel was in captivity for 70 years, and then they come back to Jerusalem. So continue.
Listen to and obey the voice
of
the Lord
your God.
Not vaguely or partly, but completely,
according to the words of Haggai the prophet, since the Lord your God had sent him.
And the people reverently feared and worshiped and turned to the Lord.
Jane talked with us. She says, have this healthy fear for God. You should have a healthy fear. Who are you listening to? Which water line coming with? One of the reasons we produce the craziness, you're very nonchalant with water. Yeah. Ontario water come in, the lake water come in. Yeah. Sometimes when people see you, you see yourself, you go, what is wrong with me? I am looking at the manifestation in the ice machine, it's brown ice, clear ice, green ice, you're like, you don't reverently take in every thought captive. Because once the thought, you see, if when Jackie to play with her husband, you understand? There's no spermatoza, there's no chance for she to bring a baby, no ice can be formed. But once there's a deposit, once it get in and you identify, the thoughts now have what? A contact point.
Yeah.
Right. If the thought passed through and you didn't identify with it, it's fine. If I can put them in the stage. How it stays is you start to, like a candy, you start to play with it, meditate it, and the flavors start to what? Be dispersed.
Yes.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? So this is what the Bible said. Take the thought captive, meaning examine it before you decide to what? Will I eat this candy? Amen? So they decide to be very careful and listen, and not in part. They'll say completely, positively, only one kind of thought's going to come in. Why do we read the Bible in fellowship? What are we trying to do? We're trying to read out one radio station.
Yes, amen.
I'm extremely careful what I listen. I don't go on the internet unless I gotta get something. Why don't I go? I don't want to know what's going on there. I have one, but you'll see. I'm in the spirit a lot. I need to know what's going on in the spirit. Because I need those formations. Because when somebody press the ice machine, I want to make sure they get what? Good.
Talking about, are you going to choose to eat this candy or not? It's like, people think they can, and they're on a diet. They can't even control what they're going to literally, physically eat.
Yes.
How much more?
Yes, yes.
Something that's unseen.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Like,
I mean,
if you can't win the invisible, you'll never win the invisible. If all your fight is too late in, it's what I preached last week, you're always behind.
Yeah.
You're always at the end and the place where it cannot be changed. The only thing you can wait is for a new load of ice to come up.
Yes.
But you can't stop the ice.
Yes.
Now, please continue, Brother Charles, you guys. Verse 14.
And the Lord aroused the spirit of Zerubbabel, the son of...
No, sorry, let me just tell you a little bit about the story, because it's the same like us. They came back from captivity, and they built up their house, and their family, and they put in a lot of work. But none of them built the house of the Lord. So the Lord, nothing wasn't working for them, and they go to the Lord, why is our country and our home suffering so much? And he goes, because you put all your time and energy on you, and you don't do nothing for my house. He goes, build my house back. Because the Babylonian had come and destroyed the temple. And he goes, after you build my house, see what happened with your house. So the Lord wants them to build something. Let's see how he gets them to build. You are supposed to live an effective life. Tell me how you're supposed to live it. Please read again from 14.
And the Lord aroused the spirit of Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and the spirit of Joshua, Jehozadak, high priest, and the spirit of all the remnant of the people. So they came and labored on the house of the Lord of hosts. Right.
How does the Lord get them to work? What is it he has to erect in them?
The spirit of all the remnant.
He wanted Zerubbabel. Yeah, he's the governor. He wanted the priests and he wanted the people. Listen to me. You will never pray in the spirit. You'll never control the water line. You'll never be an effective Christian till the spirit you have received that is not a coward and fear is aroused. The reason why you can't pray in the spirit, you don't understand the scripture. When you pray, you can't see what's happening. You can't discern. Your spirit, though it's not coward or fear, it is not aroused. It's sleeping. Are you listening to what I'm saying?
That's why there's no standard.
Your soulish life or your physical, you understand? It aroused in the contamination.
Yeah.
Stimulation. Your spirit, when it aroused the what? Righteousness. In God ain't stupid. So God really can't get them to labor properly or even labor unless he get their spirit what? Up. Do you know why God regenerates the spirit? So he can do what with it? Arouse. You know it's a ministry? One spirit that's been regenerated has been summoned to what? Be aroused. You will never execute your life or glorify God or do the things you're supposed to do until your spirit is aroused. And the Lord made it clear, he said, your spirit is not a spirit that likes to lay down. It's not coward, it's not fearful. So when you're feeling anxiety and fear, you are in the wrong part of you. You need to go, Lord, you understand? This is why the Lord always going to pick up your cross. Put away the other way you can live, so you are forced. The only thing that's left is what? Your spirit.
Amen.
Then you will pray in the spirit, walk in the spirit, live in the spirit, and you will labor in the spirit. Last week, you know, Pastor Otez and Pastor Grant been ordained. They are called to stay in the spirit. And Christ said the secret of doing that, you must deny your local life. Jing has been called to show your past. You can deny your past and now stay in the aroused position. Now Satan's job is very simple. He must stop you from being what? Aroused in the spirit. And the way we do that, next week when we go through triumphant in victory, I'm hoping to share with you how to shut down, how to stop the flesh from being aroused. If your flesh is aroused, your spirit is what? Covered up. If your spirit is aroused, the Bible said by righteousness, your flesh is what? Shut down. Are you listening to me? If your flesh is aroused, your spirit is closed. If your spirit is up, your flesh is superseded. Can you understand? God doesn't call fleshy to labor. He knows he can't get them to do what he wants them to do. They're hostile towards him. The only day a fleshy works for God is to steal the glory. When your spirit is aroused, I don't have to beg Charles to do things. Something in him is called the man of God.
Yes.
You guys remember why Jinx started driving?
Yeah.
Nobody asked.
I wanted to put a car in there.
She wanted to serve more. It's your spirit aroused. We have all kind of fear and different things. You know what makes you preach or worship? It's the spirit aroused.
Amen.
Ever so often I listen to one of you uttering something and I just shout amen or hallelujah. Do you know why? I clearly sense the spirit, man, arouse. And ever so often you're careless and I see another water line. Notice I ignore you.
Yeah.
I will never say amen to the flesh when it's arouse.
Yeah.
I simply don't even participate. I pretend that person is dead, there's nobody there. I don't even acknowledge. You may not pay attention. Oh, you notice? Walk in your spirit and you will always get. Amen. When the Lord summoning you to do something, He always arouses your what? Your spirit.
Yeah.
Whether it's for the labor, whether it's to be a priest or to be a governor. Does it make sense? This morning I come and know Pastor Chow was preaching. One of the first things I look to see was aroused.
Yes.
I lay eyes on him. I go, beautiful, wonderful. I could tell he's been staying consecrated that the spirit is what? Aroused. No, Satan fully understands this. And he has a million ways to shut your what? Spirit down.
Yes.
If you can keep it aroused, trust. Also that same agar. Can you give me 1 Corinthians 1:3? I believe Jing Shoyo, our pastor, she show you where she has come, and Pastor Nikki, and our church is exactly there. She's ordained. Every one of our life, every one of us have a story like Jing. I typically don't focus on the past. I focus on your present and where you're going. I believe this is what's going to happen in our church and in the body of Christ, in those that allow the Lord to arouse them throughout the realms. Because God have many, many children, but not all of them allows their spirit to what? Be aroused.
Yes.
Meaning, Agai chapter 2, right where we are.
Chapter 2. Okay.
Chapter 2, verse 21 to 23. If your spirit, I know many Christians, but in every 10, I might, or maybe 100, I can show you 2 that the spirit is what? Aroused. The rest of them, their flesh is very pronounced. Soon as you meet them, all you can sense is there. No, it's not the spirit is not trying to come up. It just can't. Can listen to me. What you are focusing in is that part is what? Expanded. And what you focus on the longest, or you have faith or trust in, that becomes the what? The strongest. You guys know my wife. Mama is mighty strong physically. Trust me with this, and I guarantee each one of you will testify. She's a billion times stronger in the spirit. Don't ever encourage her physical strength. I never would. But I'm constantly challenging her. I know God gave her a spirit of power. You understand? To release the pure spike in her, keep it aroused.
Amen.
Instead of the flesh.
Amen.
I know for a fact, my sister Jackie is a true prophetess.
Amen.
I give her almost no notice when she showed me the flesh. I might be polite, but I never what? Encourage it. But I'm always praying and encouraging her to release the spirit that has been resurrected.
Amen.
We will get nothing from her until she can say habitually what? I'm talking good stuff. And the other stuff you should just regenerate. Sister Gloria is regenerate mighty in the spirit. She'll be a mighty woman of prayer. But until she learned to deny herself and stay.
Come on.
Well,
stay aroused.
You know me and Mama, we look at the church and we pray, we're talking about family. I love Brother Charles, I really do. I love all of you. No, but this, I'm focusing right now. One of the biggest mysteries in our church is Charles. Charles is a quiet person. And if he has it his way, he'll stay quiet and reserved. But because of the time we live in, we can't keep him there. We need him.
Amen.
The body needs him. I am telling you, when Charles become clear on certain things, because Jake, someone like you or even myself, Charles don't have our kind of baggage. Charles' baggage is ignorance. It's not he messed up his physical life that much. He's just ignorant.
Not a lot of healing.
He don't have a lot of need to fix. He just need to get clear on what he has become and what is an around spirit. What is it? He needs to be clear. And I tell you, when he figured this out, you'll go, where have you been? You apologize. You go, I just didn't see it yet. I wasn't sure how it works. Believe me, he's a quiet uniqueness. I can't wait for him to come forth.
Amen.
I can't. This some most of you have seen something, but Charles is somebody I am looking forward to see.
Amen.
I am looking forward for his in the darkness to clear up.
Amen.
And this season it shall clear up.
Hallelujah.
It shall clear up. There are two principles. You need to deny yourself and you need to embrace the resurrection life. What stops us is these two challenges. You're not clear on the resurrected life, and you don't deny yourself. You can't have both life. You can't have your spiritual life and your physical life. One, the Bible says, you have to lose one to find the other. He said, those who lose their life will find their life. But if we do, and we will, please read from verse 21. Speak of Zerubbabel. So this is Agai. So I'll just read verse 20. Verse 20 said, and again the word of the Lord came to Agai on the 24th day, amen, of the month, saying, what did he say? Verse 21.
Speak to Zerubbabel.
That's the governor.
Representative of the
Davidic. He's from the Davidic monarchy, exactly like you.
And covenant in direct line of ancestry of Jesus Christ, the governor of Judah, saying, I will shake the heavens and the earth.
We read the song this morning, we listened to the song. You know, when your glory what? Shakes the heaven and earth. You know what I'm saying? God said, I am going to shake up heaven and I'm going to shake up earth. I am telling you, we have been for a while. We are in the season of what? Shaking. We worshiped it this morning, you know. One of the new songs we're singing, you understand?
Yeah.
His glory shakes the heaven. Yes.
Yes.
Hear it? Yes. Continue.
And I will, in the distant future, overthrow the thrones of kingdoms. And I will destroy the strength of the kingdoms of the ungodly nations. And I will overthrow the chariots and those who ride in them. And the horses and their riders shall go down, every one, by the sword of his brother.
Uh-huh. So in all the shaking, God said, all those in power, I'm going to switch up everything. The shaking is, all who are masters and governors and who running company, he said, I'm going to shake it up all. He said, I'm going to make all of it collapse. Now why? Listen to me. This world is collapsing. Nothing can be done to stop it because it has a place it's going.
Yeah.
We're in the Messianic era. Please continue.
In that day, says the Lord of hosts, will I take you, O Zerubbabel, my servant, the son of Shealtiel, says the Lord, and will make you through the Messiah.
How is he going to make it? Through the Messiah, the same way we are forged. We are all of the Messiah water line. What? You are kingdom citizen brought in by the Messiah and living through the forging of the Messiah.
Wow.
Your thoughts are supposed to be positively forged. All of your discipline is because typically we allow other thoughts to come in. Then the Holy Spirit disciplining. He said, stop your adultery.
Yes.
He's greater than
you. You're creating different eyes. Stop that. We don't, that's inappropriate eyes, defile eyes. You're letting people drink the defile eyes. Hallelujah. Please continue.
Your descendant, my sick man, for I have chosen you as the one with whom to renew my covenant to David's line, says the Lord of hosts.
Amen. We are in this time where you have been chosen into the Davidic monarchy. And God said, I'm going to shake up everything. I am going to shake up everything. Amen. Because he wants to make everything, amen. You see, he said, the latter shall be greater than what? The former.
Perfect.
You see? He said, I am shaking up everything.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
That the latter shall be greater, yes, amen, than the former. In that same Agai verse 8 reads, the silver is mine and the gold is mine, saith the Lord of hosts. The latter glory of this house, amen, with its successor to which Jesus came, shall be greater than the former, saith the Lord of hosts. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And in this place will I give peace and prosperity, saith the Lord. I mark this in the name of Jesus, and I'm witness. I speak now from the proper water line.
Amen.
Every one of your life, you hear?
Amen.
The latter part shall be a billion times greater. Sister Gloria, you're not done yet.
Amen.
You're not done yet.
Amen.
You're not done yet. The last part of your life shall be greater than your first part of your life. I promise you, the last part, Jing thinks she has come far. She hasn't come yet.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jing thinks she has come, and she has come, but where she's going. Are you listening? You just needed to get her erect, aroused. And if she stay in the spirit, or any one of you,
Jazzy, you're not done yet. In fact, you just begin. You've only just begun. Hey, listen to it. The last part of your life, it will not be dear to compare with the former. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Because the church are those whose spirit has been around. Didn't you testify to your in-law? Yes, it's true. Typically, as we try to stay resurrect, for a little while you fall in the flesh, your spirit. Every time you fall in the flesh, you have closed the spirit. It's like, I think Pastor Chow said it, I think. It's like putting a wet blanket over it. This is what I talk about last week, traveling light. What is traveling light? I must stay in the aroused position. Are you listening to what I'm saying? I must stay in the erect position. Now Satan's job is to pull you back into gravity. There's a million ways. You need to, through the spirit, stay out. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Stay out. If you got a fellowship every day, but what you're discovering in the resurrected position, that altitude, hey, I discovered it, call and fellowship every day. If you have to pray or commune or read, you do what it takes that you stay erect. And you better stay away from what grounds you. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Some of us, it's like Jazzy Lorne, we have these wonderful story that keeps us in our history. Let me teach you a secret.